Hello, and in this tutorial what we're going to do is create images that can toggle and images that can change size. So you're welcome back to another tutorial. In this one, we've got two discrete parts. We're going to make an image change, swap between two different pictures, and we're going to make a picture get smaller and larger. So in our designer, we're only going to have two components. The first one is an image, and here I'm using the picture set to be an image that I've uploaded already. And the second thing then is going to be the button. Eventually we'll have one to make the image smaller and larger, but just starting off, what we'll do is we'll have one button to toggle the image. So in our blocks, the code is very simple. This is very much like our toggle button that we had earlier on. And we're going to do a quick if-else statement in here. So rather than using the logic values, rather than using the Boolean values like we used before, what we're going to do is check based on the name. So image1.picture, that image1.picture property. At the moment, what we've done is we've got it set to sunny.png, so make sure that you've got the full file name, including the file extension there, so sunny.png. That's what it's set to at the moment. So if it's already sunny.png, what we'll do is we'll change it to be a different picture. So we put in another string like this, and we can use one of the other images that we have, checked.png or auto-renew, let's say. So auto-renew is this little rotating arrow that we used in another tutorial as well. So toggling the image like this then swaps back and forth. If it's sunny, change to auto renew. If it's auto renew, change it back to sunny. And that's it. That's all for toggling images. Now, if you want to help the channel out, help us grow a little bit, really appreciate everybody that subscribed recently. If you'd like to get notified of new videos, make sure you click on the bell icon. Part two now in the tutorial, what we'll do is we'll add in two buttons, one to make the image larger and one to make the image smaller. So button one, what we'll do is say increase image size, and you can probably guess what we're going to do then. We'll drag and drop in a second button later on, and that'll be for decreasing the image size. So let's check it out. Let's get one working first of all. So it'll be the button one dot click event like this. And what do we do then? Well, we want to change its dimensions. So we want to change the height and the width of the image. What we're going to do is we'll go into the maths section then, and we can add on a fixed amount. So we can increase this by 10 pixels, for example, if we do a plus 10. And what are we going to add that onto? It's going to be added on to the image height for image height setter, and the image width will be increased by 10 for the image width setter. So every time we click the button now, we get the image gets bigger in height and width by 10 pixels. Cool. Okay, so that seems pretty straightforward. Let's try to do that again. This time we'll go back, we'll add in our second button. Instead of being increase the image size, it's going to be decrease the image size. And so that means then that in our blocks, rather than adding on 10 or adding on some amount, what we'll do is that when the second button is clicked, we're going to subtract. So you go into math again, you find the minus block, just like that. We're going to need two of them, one for the height and one for the width. And we've got 10 coded in here. So maybe if you wanted to make this a little bit more maintainable, what you could do is put in a variable here, and we could have it set to a constant value rather than having to change those 10s all the time. If you wanted to get bigger by 20 pixels or get smaller by 5 pixels perhaps. So working really nicely so far. If you like what you've seen so far, please click on the thumbs up button to show your support. The final little thing that we're going to do then is also scaling, but rather than doing addition and subtraction, what we'll do is we'll use this multiply block. So the times block there, we'll multiply by 1.1. And what that has the effect of doing then is making the height 10% greater. So multiply by 1.1 means be slightly larger than it was, be 10% bigger than it was. And we can do the exact same thing with the width as well. And then for the decreasing in size, we can still use the multiply block, but if we use a number less than 1. So here what we do is we set it to be 0.9, and that means be 90% of the size that it used to be. Great, so let's try that out. It should look very similar in terms of performance. So clicking increase makes it the image bigger, clicking decrease then will make the image smaller. Okay, so that's the end of the video. Thank you to everybody who's made it this far. As per usual, leave all your comments and questions in the comment section below. Any links to the project files are in the description. Thank you very much for watching. I'll see you in the next tutorial.